Sports Night Amplified with Andile on Metro FM. Monday through Friday, 6 to 7 p.m. Game over.
I did promise you that we're very excited here to host a young man that I am very proud of. Can you give us a big round of applause there? Siyabonga Ngezane joins us. FSCB defender and Bafana Bafana defender, former Kaizer Chiefs Academy product who won the Romanian Liga title, helping the champions to their first in 9 years. Siya.
Eita, my brother.
Yazi ngithi uzongishaya nge-accent inyana.
Ah, next. Siya,
Siya, congratulations, man.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I can imagine. I mean, I looked at your Instagram. I saw everything that you've been doing, the excitement to get there in the first season, and you lift a trophy. You must be so proud of yourself.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, Tanibingelela, my listeners, away Metro FM. Yeah, I mean, I'm very, very excited. More especially, it's my first title. So, yeah, I'm very, very excited.
It is your first title ever, isn't it?
Yes, it's my first title ever.
Well, see, I like how you're with them as well, boy.
Yeah, I understand. Sometimes things, they don't go according to the plan.
Your first title ever, and it's in Romania. But also, Sia, you know, I said to myself, I was looking at the stats, I thought there's an element of persistence when you got there. You know, you didn't get there and then get into the starting 11 and you were the boss there. No, it was a bit of a challenge as well to get in there. An injury happened and then you got a chance. Talk to me about those first months, getting to a foreign country, to a foreign team.
Yeah, okay. Obviously, first of all, Ngasho Guti, obviously, beginnings are not always easy. Coming to the foreign land, the culture, the language. So I needed to adapt. Actually, the environment, like the weather. So I needed to adapt. Also, get familiar with the place, with the players. Yeah. So it wasn't easy. So it was not a walk in the park. I had to work hard to be dedicated.
And what was the biggest barrier when I'm in Sierra? I mean, the language I can imagine as well. But I always say when I'm traveling around the world, I have to kind of find the food that Engichwaelings or was weird. What were some of the biggest shocks for you arriving in Romania?
Oh, arriving in Romania, okay. I was grateful with Labantu Lava, actually. Bakuluma English.
Oh, really?
But yes, they can speak English. But the only thing, their first language, obviously, is their home language. You understand? It's a Romanian language. And then you can find some other players, they don't know English. You understand? They only know Romanian. Now you need to a translator, also communicator with some of the players. You understand? So, yeah, also the food, back at home, there are things that you used to eat. And then, it's a place in it whereby they also in Sizwama takeaway. Otherwise, it's a country in religious also. It's also like they like their culture, their food that they eat. It's their own culture food. You understand?
But so it's right, man.
So now I think try because I also try new things, try new food because I've been in a different country, So I also have my favorite, one of the favorite dish in Itanda, that's the problem. They use their own language and then.
Are you learning it though? Are you learning a little Romanian?
Yes, I'm learning. I'm learning every day. There's an app that I use actually, Duolingo, so it helps me with language
and translation.
Yes.
And then upon arrival, I mean, here in South Africa, you knew you were a good player. You knew you were a big player. I mean, you were part of the national team even. So that already says you're one of the best players. Yeah. When you arrive in Romania, we've seen many South Africans buy at work and to Turkey, etc., and they never get to play because when they get there, they realize the level is different. How did you find the level in the Romanian league?
To be honest, to come here, like I knew Guti, is far away, like, you know, to take that decision, because like it has been one of my dreams to play in Europe. You know, as a youngster, you always want to play in Europe, you understand? So it was part of the plan, you know. So obviously, I had to have a room of improvement, which is going to be hard, I know, and I need to work on it. Things won't come easily. I need to fight for a position. Yeah, but through dedication, hard work, like it, I'm opportunities and to be consistent to be in the team. Yeah.
Where did they see you playing? Because, I mean, you can play on the left, you can play centrally as well. When you got there, started training, the reason they brought you to the team, where are they comfortable playing you?
Actually, the reason why they like, but why I'm saying it's because of they saw I'm a strength arm, you know, as a player, you know. So in that position, be free. Actually, they wanted someone there.
Centrally. So,
yeah, centrally, because of they look at the heart, they will look at the speed, you know. So those things, these are was paying like a cool Google, like good. So some of the things I can improve. So yeah, Bangwen is centrally.
And then once you got that opportunity, once you started playing, you said, "I am Sapumgle 11."
Yeah, because you know, obviously, like it's very hard. Like, for an example, like come from South Africa, more especially among figure, like it wasn't easy because of Opuma. From it's like in terms of I'm a standard, I can say Puma from South Africa in Africa, and obvious like Ngapa, like in Europe, they are ahead, they beat ahead than us, you understand?
Ahead Ngani?
Ahead in terms of the level.
Mm.
Yes. So it was a bit hard because of I had to prove it, like needs prove it. They made the right choice.
So you're telling me from where you came from here, Mofiga Lapana, there were still things that you needed to gain more food and more before you could be on that level now?
Yes, because like, you know, like these people, there are things like being as us, you know, but like, fortunately enough, I do think adapt goes because of, for an example, they are very detailed, and then smaller information is very important, and it can win you games, you know. But sometimes you tend to like before, I didn't see as an important thing, you know, that thing, you know. So they are very detailed, someone like Ngapa. And then another things, yeah, and Banama basics, they master my basics.
Basics like, and then like trepi bola, pega, crosser, things like that.
To keep things simple, also at the right time, at the right place, you know.
Are you telling me, Sia, that at 26, leaving South Africa, those are some of the things that we get to Europe and fanege bas Polish shoguzo?
No, for me, Andy Lengash with body positioning, you understand? Those are the things that are light. Mm. It's not like us in South Africa, we don't train them, but we take them light, maybe as players. You understand?
And Lapo when I like to say Lagzona, they emphasize
and then those
goes.
Things, they are very important, and they are small, but they are very important. Understand, because of in South African, bear in mind, South Africans are very talented. It's proven, Guafcon. It's proven. We know in football, just that like we need some of the things, you know, to master and to get there.
Hmm.
So I can say
that's interesting to me, you know, because you don't often hear that from players to say, hey, these were our challenges when we get there. And we don't get to see you play there. So are you telling me that if I look at the last games you played here in South Africa and look at the games that you're playing now, I'm going to see a completely different player? I'm going to see some growth.
Uzobona growth, yes. I think uzobona growth because now I'm improving every day, you know, and I try, you know, to improve every day. So I think uzobona a bit it growth. Now as a man, like I can see with it, like I've grown up in some areas.
You mentioned AFCON. You said to me now that, you know, you were watching the boys play. How did you feel watching the boys play from where you were?
Watching the boys? Yeah, it's like, to be honest, it was nice watching the boys, like, playing, more especially achieving until Kumasemis. It was really nice. I was very proud of being a South African, because you also, I also had to watch, and then they were obvious, like they knew Ngapagut, Afghaniya and stuff. And a disappointing thing was I couldn't make the final squad.
Mm.
You understand? That's why only that disappointment things Ngabana. But other than that, I was very proud of the boys.
But it showed as well that Coach Hugo Bruce hadn't forgotten about you, because then the next time he needed to call up, I think it was Algeria match, you know, you were called up to that game and you couldn't make it, we're told.
Yeah. It shows good, yeah, you know, I'm still in his head, yeah. It shows good also, and with an awareness, which they also follow games that you play, like, you know, European players, they also follow their games. So, because it's not easy. No one is like seeing our games this side. So it's very hard, that side with us born, you understand?
And that's something you want. You want to be back in that Bafana fold. You want your place in that Bafana team.
Yeah, I want to, you know, cement my position nationally. It's very important, more especially when you play in Europe. You need to, like, we have like a lot of national players. So it's very important, me as a player, represent my own country.
Now, listen, we can't wait to see you in that Bafana one as well. But also, I'm excited because South Africans might get to watch you now, because winning the league means, of course, qualifying for European football.
Yeah, we qualify, but obviously, but not like Ngatini. We are entitled to be qualified, but we still need to play. Some few matches, I think.
Yeah, because you're coming from the Romanian league. Of course, there's a qualification, further qualification matches that get you now into the group stages is where you've got to go. But that in its own is European football. You get to be on that stage.
Yes, yeah, it's very exciting. And, you know, I'm very excited to Uti. I'm looking forward to Uti. At least if we can get there and qualify on my group stage or Champions League.
I'm sure also no clara la pukaba mute. Must not tell you group kabanga says that Napo Real Madrid.
Yeah, you wish one day, you wish with, yeah, one day. But like it's unreal until it happened, you know. It's unreal for now, like, you know. Until we born a Yenzangala, yeah, it's unreal.
See, here's another thing. I mean, you look at those leagues, Romanian leagues, Turkish leagues, Portuguese leagues that a lot of African players go to, Europe, because most of them, it's a hope, it's going to take me to a better league. But I often wonder, when you leave the top of the game like you do, you didn't go to Romania surely to say, the money's good, yeah, it's better, I'm getting way more than what I was getting at home, so let me go and play there, Romanian league is my dream. Surely there's a lot more to it than that.
Yes, yeah. As a player, obviously, maybe you have your own targets. Yeah, so I have my own targets now. I'm good as a player. I want to see myself maybe in one day, maybe in the top five league, you know. So I wish one day. So now, like in Romania, a good thing about being this side in Europe, because we Central European up, which we are next to opportunities, you know. Anything happens, like there are a lot of eyes that are watching, you know, and my scouts, like there are a lot of opportunities. So yeah, I think I want to see myself somewhere, you know. Yeah,
because I mean, I've heard now people saying you know, there's scouts that are asking about you, there's people in Europe that are looking at you. I'm sure you're trying to put your head down and you're saying, hey, but you can't ignore it, Sia. As much as you want to put your head down, be humble and put the work in and focus and give your team, you know, all the credit. Because, I mean, they gave you a chance and you've brought them here and they've brought you here. But you can't ignore Intus Fananales, I'm sure.
Yes. Yes. Like, you know, been doing it last time. Like, someone asked me about offers. I said, look, yeah, people always want to talk, you know. But, like, the most important thing for me right now to talk about something solid, you know, I can't, because I'm a rumors at the end of the day, you know, it's not something solid. So I try to work hard, you know, but it shows the recognition, and it's also young pusher, you know, it gives me drive. I must do more on myself.
As soon as you won it, as soon as the final whistle went, Mofiga, go change room, Mubambi phone. Who's the first person you called?
To be honest, and then you won't believe, but to be honest, that's the last thing like I checked, like to take up my like calls, like or anything. But like before, I have people that I call before, you know, before the game. But after the game, after the celebration, I was not on my phone because of the excitement and the celebration. It was the last thing, you know, I could maybe check. Then I started maybe to check my call. I didn't call anyone that time. I only posted, you know. That's the only thing I didn't call because everyone was sleeping by that time in Czechophonia. And then we played the night game. It was a night game.
Yeah, so yeah.
In South Africa, because we are ahead, I think that time, Bebelele, you know. So I didn't call anyone.
Are you still friendly with your former colleagues at Kaizer Chiefs, the players? Are you still boys with them? Are you still having conversations? Do you guys still talk?
Yeah, we still talk. Yeah, some of my former colleagues are here. Yeah, we definitely talk, but like not as much as before, you know. Not as much as before, but like you just lap on a lap, you know. More special people I was close with Kakul, maybe Abu Bruce, just, you know, Kutazan, lap on a lap.
And then I always say, Mansiego, Europe is so small. To jump into the next country is a train away or an hour's flight away. There's South African players all around Europe. Is there anybody that you're particularly close to?
I've met Thabo Tsele.
Oh, yeah.
He's playing in, I think, in Russia. He's playing in Russia. So he was the only guy whereby, since the preseason, he was next to me, like, in Turkey. So besides that, in pre-season in Turkey, it was Jenner, I think. I mean, pre-season. So he was the only guy who visited me that time. And then, obviously, we linked before now, Guma Juniors. So I played with him. So he was the only guy that Zengahlangana naye the side. And it was so exciting.
You know, we don't have the cameras in studio because it's a public holiday like Kaya. So it's workers' day. Normally, you have cameras here. People would see how big my smile is because, you know, I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of you. And we're not even having an interview here. We're having a chat. Because I can't believe this. You know, you work so hard and your first title ever comes in a foreign country. What is the fan experience like, Sia? How different is it from, I mean, you are part of the biggest team in South Africa, you know, with the most demanding fans as far as Kaizer Chiefs is concerned. What is the fan experience like, Mose Romania? What are those fans like? Is it any different? Is it still, you know, more Mr. Poleli Wan Bakora, they're on you? Is it more supportive? Injani experience of my fans,
Angara? To be honest, okay, if I can compare, because of I know the culture, it Chiefs, like, you know, demanding and stuff. Obviously, like, but they were running out of patience, you know. But the only difference that I saw, right, that side, the same situation, Benguso, and then thinking, when I moved to Europe, maybe a breaking, you know, get a breaking from the pressure, you know. But, like, it was the same situation whereby now they are running, like, it route now go they like bagu drought, like they won the league, you know. It's been 9 years, and then where I come from, it is maybe close to 10 years now, like, yeah, like Boma 10 years not winning the cup with Chiefs. So
that's why I'm asking you, because when you got to Romania as well, it was a team that hadn't won in so long. You had Kaizer Chiefs, a team that hadn't won in so long. Hence, you know, you were in two very similar situations.
So okay, Guma fan, I think Guma supporters here, like, they are more like encouraging more. They are encouraging more in terms of like small things, you know, small things. Because I remember, you know, maybe making a mistake, like they are like behind you until the end, you know. But like, because niching, it's like here they're like small thing, like they clap for you, like unganze tackle and then clap for you, like not good to melo zokore, understand, to be recognized with you had been, but like smaller things, they encourage you, like
they are very courageous, like by having courage the most, I can say that. And then you can connect with their energies, you know, you can connect with their energies.
Oh, Siyabonga Gezana is our guest all the way from Mania. If you're listening, you can hear the smile on his face. South Africa, your very own, the son of the soil from this land, has gone to nations beyond and won it. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, one or two more questions. I see most of you wanting to ask Propilani. I'll get to him with that question as well. And we'll all wrap it up with the champion.
Sports Night Amplified with Andile on Metro FM. Proudly brought to you by SABC Sports.
Champion of the Romanian League, FSCB defender and Bafana Bafana defender, Siyabonga Gezana. Are we sure the team yako siya ini kamalayo?
It's FCSB.
Mara Marcel Pele.
Yeah, it's the star of FCSB. Like, but like, by using my abbreviation ngakhona, that's why.
Yeah, ngoba uyalizwa now, we
are. Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to give you just some quick fire questions here that we've received. You know, Athazwane was a mentor to you, was like a father figure to you. Do you guys still have a relationship? Do you still talk?
Yeah. We still catch up, yeah. Because I remember the time I went in South Africa for a break. I once, we still talk. We still look at Sakulu.
Oh, no, that's good to know. He must be very proud of you. And then the team that you play for, what kind of football do you guys play? What's the philosophy of football there?
The style of play, I think it's it's a positioning team. Like we play at the back, starting from the back, and yeah, we are more positioning team.
Also, you're the kind of team that holds the ball at the back. You have to play it out from the back, position based team.
Yes.
Is that very similar to what Bafana is? Then I would think.
Yeah, it's very similar. Yeah, it's very similar. Style of play, sub, I think, is very similar.
Okay, I'm going to let you go. I'm now so sorry, but before I let you go, Mbana, I'm sure Isaga lele hada, ne?
Isaga. Not too much, just there.
But it's a huge improvement from here at home.
Yes, kakhulu.
Kakhulu, Siya! So yeah, listen, we're gonna go with you on this journey. If you stay at FCCB, if you move somewhere else, we are team whatever you're supporting. So I told Amachezakona, so what Goga, because we're supporting you. I'm very proud of you. I can't even imagine. It's like one of my own little brothers has gone and done something amazing. Thank you for talking to us. Thank you for talking to South Africans. If you are on Twitter, I'm not sure if you're on X. I know you're on Instagram. I'm not sure if you're on X, but South Africans are proud of you.
I'm only on Facebook and Instagram only.
Well, I can tell you now that the support for you and what you did was immense. South Africans are proud of you. We are exceptionally proud of you. When you do come back here, please let us know. We'd love to see you. We'd love to host you. Ladies and gentlemen, a South African winner in Romania. And I think also, Timmy must look it up. He's the first South African to win a title in Romania. See, I think you're the first South African to win a title in Romania.
Oh, I didn't know this.
I don't remember a South African player winning in Romania. I'll look it up. I'll get our statisticians here to look it up. But I think you're the first South African to win in Romania and win a league. So that's a big one as well. Thank you so much for talking to us, boy. And all the best. You're a champion!
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you so much.
And also, guys, I must let you know, Sia doesn't enjoy interviews. He doesn't like doing interviews. So we're very lucky and we're grateful. Nyabonga, boy.
Nyabonga, Khatman. Thank you.
Chap. He's out of here. Siyabonga Gezana.